Blog Talk Radio.
Another Free For All Wednesday show. This is our fourth and final for the month of January until further notice. We won't have another one until March. We won't have any next month, just so everyone knows. So let's see. Well, let me go ahead and remind everybody to register on Blog Talk Radio and follow the show so you get reminders, and that way you're completely aware of and you don't miss a minute of the show. Also, please like our fan page on Facebook. All you have to do is go to www.facebook.com/talkintheshadows and you will find us there. Also, we are on Google+. We are also on Twitter. So if you look up Talk in the Shadows, you'll be sure to find us those places as well. So I'm going to go ahead and welcome Robin to the show. Welcome, Robin.
Hello. Good evening. How are you? You know, I got
I'm
it right.
I'm doing pretty good.
Yeah,
how
I
are
got
you?
It right. Well,
oh, you're
I'm doing good. Yeah, I got a gripe. You know,
okay.
I used to be your announcer girl, and now you've taken me out of a job, Lise.
Sorry. You want to go back to being the announcer girl?
So, yeah, it'll be interesting to see who calls in tonight, what interesting things. I'm sure you have some interesting things to share. Interesting. Yeah?
Yeah, maybe our show will be all about interesting things. That sounds interesting.
Yeah.
So, well, let's go ahead and get the show started. Looks like we've got a couple people waiting to talk, so let's go ahead and answer.
Good.
Oh, wait, we got the doorbell. Let me make sure I turn that down a bit. Remember how loud it was. Oh, looks like I got a caller. Let's answer that. Welcome to the show. Is this Denise?
Yeah, this is me. How you girls doing?
Hey.
Hey. Wednesday night. Ready for the show?
Awesome.
So I'm kind of bummed that you just said that there's no Wednesday nights, there's no Wednesday phone calls in February. What's up with that?
Well,
Yeah,
we've got a really busy schedule for February as far as the show. There's a lot of planning involved, and I just have a lot going on right now, so I'm not going to be able to devote two days a week, not for February. And I'll definitely come up with what exactly we're going to do after that, but probably at least one show per month that we'll have for that type of show every month. But for now, we are going to be taking the Wednesday shows off for next month.
So. Yeah. Well, I think everybody should be calling in on Sundays for next month. That's all about love and romance and men and women.
Absolutely.
Oh, it's going to be great. I can't wait. I can't wait for February. I'm excited. Did I tell you that? I'm excited. It's going to be a great show. Yeah, I'm excited.
And she just can't hide it.
Yeah.
Okay, so let's go ahead and get some more people up here. Next caller. Oh, wait, another doorbell. Hello, welcome to the show. Is this Matt?
Yes,
oh.
Ma'am. How are you?
I am doing well.
I don't know how I'm going to actually answer that because Robin was starting to sing, you know, I'm so excited. And I just wanted to almost finish that for her right when I came
yeah.
out. And I just can't find it. I'm about to lose control, you know, and I was like, no. I'm
no, that was
that.
That was actually Shadow singing. That was actually Shadow's voice. Yeah.
Well, either one, I apologize.
We're on the show so much, we end up sounding alike.
Both have beautiful singing voices, and so it just... Yeah, you guys sounded pretty good there. I don't know. Anyway, and then I heard the interesting thing, right? And so I was gonna be like, oh, I got some interesting. I burnt my thumb on a Pop Tart earlier.
Did you put ice on it?
On a Pop Tart.
Okay, so tell our listeners how you medicated yourself from burning yourself on a Pop Tart. They might need to know that in the future.
Or did you injure the Pop Tart and have to take it to the emergency room?
I rinsed it off in cool water. Made sure I used a cotton rag, not like a nice towel. That's hard. Then I have little triple antibiotic ointment little packets. I won't say where I got. I got them from a source. And then
okay.
I bandaged it up, and now I look like a hitchhiker that tried to shoot heroin in his thumb. I guess I don't know.
You know what? If I use my psychic ability, I bet you I can tell you where you got that triple antibiotic ointment. Would it be from hold on. Let me think. Would it be from a work first aid kit? You know how they have
No, actually it would not be, but good guess.
Well, that was my good guess, so you know how psychic I am anyway.
How did you know that, Robin? Wow, stay out of my brain.
Okay, well, looks like we got another caller. Let's go ahead and get them on the line. I got to get used to doing the doorbell first, though. I'll get better at this. Wear it. Welcome to the show. Is this Dave?
I think
what
we need an
heck?
Applause. We haven't had this visitor in quite a long time.
Are you
so
still
Dave,
there?
Hello?
Hello?
Hello.
So I hear you're a little under the weather. Are you feeling okay?
I'm feeling much better, my friend.
That is so good. I'm so glad you didn't miss our show today.
Oh, I'm so glad also because, you know, you really rubbed it in about missing last week's.
Did I? I just told you what we talked about. I'm sorry. Did you listen to it? Did you get a chance to listen to it?
No.
You could have at least said, yeah, of course. It was great.
You know,
yeah, you'll
have
to. Oh, yeah, we need another fail here. Let's see. Let's just do this one. Yeah, that just blew up. That's okay, Dave. So we forgive you. So, well, Robin and I were kind of talking about some interesting things and, you know, there's a lot of weird stuff out there, bizarre laws and freaky facts and stuff like that. So I came up with some really weird law stuff. I'm going to scroll down to Ohio just because I live in Ohio.
To all the stalkers out there, if you want to find Shadow, she's in Ohio.
Yeah, it's a pretty big state, so. Okay. It says, in Oxford, Ohio, it's illegal for a woman to strip off her clothing while standing in front of a man's picture.
Wow.
Wow, that's bizarre.
Denise, you can never go to Ohio. Oh, sorry.
Yeah, Jeff Tate's picture, that's what Denise always does, right?
Oh, like, yeah, let's not mention that on air.
Oh, yeah, we probably shouldn't let people know that. Ooh, sorry, Denise. Oh, and women aren't allowed to wear patent leather shoes in Cleveland, Ohio. A man might see the reflection of something he aren't.
Wow.
Oh, I wear patent
these
leather
are
shoes.
Wait, Cleveland. These are actual laws?
Yes.
Laws from when? The 1800s?
I don't know, but these are laws. Let me see what it says in the starting paragraph here. Da, 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 da.
Man, I want to be rebellious. I'm going to take my patent leather shoes to Ohio.
Just keep in mind these laws still exist today. Obviously, they don't abide by them. I've been wearing patent leather shoes in Ohio since I was a kid. Uh-oh.
That's another show.
We're talking about patent leather. Oh, let's see. Let's find some other states here. Dee-dee-dee. Let's go to Washington.
Not Washington.
Okay, all lollipops are banned. Uh-oh.
What?
It says all lollipops are banned. No kidding. It says, a law to reduce crime states. It is mandatory for motorists with criminal intentions to stop at the city limits and telephone the chief of police as he is entering the town. Okay.
Yeah.
I just wanted to let you know I'm about to commit a crime, okay?
I won't do that.
Yeah, make sure to do that when you're in Washington. It's illegal in Wilbur, Washington, to ride an ugly horse. Who makes... Oh. Sorry, sir, your
you know,
horse
that is true.
Too ugly.
I really abide by that.
Are you sure about that, Robin?
Absolutely.
I saw a picture of you and your horse the other week. I don't know. Yeah, it gives another meaning to F you and the horse you rode in on.
Ooh, boy.
But I'm pumped. Okay.
Yeah.
There was a law in the books in Washington State that stated that a motor car driven at night must be preceded by something like 100 yards by a man carrying a lantern. Are people, like, stoned when they do these things?
Paranoid.
In Seattle, Washington, it is illegal to carry a concealed weapon that is over 6 feet in length. Who the hell carries a 6 foot gun or a knife? Well, 6 feet. I can't even imagine.
How do you hide that?
Carrying Bill around and then some. I mean, actually, he's taller than 6 feet, but still, who the hell would carry a weapon that long?
Hmm.
Are there even swords that long?
No comment.
It says it's still an offense in Washington State to pretend your parents are rich. Oh, Robin, you've been saying your parents were rich for years when you grew up. You didn't get busted, did you?
I grew up in California. You got the wrong Robin.
Oh, right. You're supposed to play along.
See?
You're not good at that.
Oh, okay. I'm sorry.
Okay. All right.
I only brag about being rich now.
There's only one for Virginia. It says in Norfolk, Virginia, a woman can't go out without wearing a corset. There was a civil service job for men only called a corset inspector. Oh, what a job. I'm sorry, miss. I have to check if you have a corset on. You need to pull your shirt up. Let me see that. Oh, no corset. No bra. Hmm.
I can't believe it's Virginia. This state is so conservative. This is the Commonwealth. This is not a liberal state at all. There's got to be, like, a ton more of those.
That's the only one for this website. I can always look up other ones. Let's see about California.
Mm-hmm.
Holy crap, there's a ton. Okay. In California, it's legal to possess bear's gallbladders. Sorry, Dave. You can't go get a gallbladder from a bear and replace your own. It's not going to happen. In California, it's illegal to trip horses for entertainment. Sorry, Dave.
See,
all your fun.
Yeah, I was going to go to Disneyland and trip some horses. My plans are foiled.
Oh, man. You're going to have to change that all up. In Blythe, California, a person must own 2 cows in order to legally wear cowboy boots in public. Oh, Dave, you're getting
That's
busted
awesome.
Again.
That is awesome. I agree with that one.
In Los Angeles, a man is legally entitled to beat his wife with a leather belt or strap, but the belt can't be wider than 2 inches unless he has his wife's consent to beat her with a wider strap.
See, that's what I'm talking about.
That's legal? Holy crap!
And so we're not going to take domestic violence in California.
So it's legal. It's like against the law not to beat your wife. Is that what that is?
Well, no. It's her consent.
If you must beat your wife, you must something larger than 2 inches. Or can't be wider.
With
my
wife beater tank top.
It is illegal to set a mouse trap without a hunting license. Wow. So catching mice is a hunting thing now in California.
You know, you don't have to rob a bank. You don't have to kill someone, okay? You just have to set a mouse trap. I'm telling you, you want to be rebellious. You want to break the law. You need to
you
beat
rat people
with
out.
More than 2 inches wide and, you know, set a mouse trap.
Exactly.
Be a bad guy one day, you know? Hey, live large.
Community leaders passed an ordinance that makes it illegal for anyone to try and stop a child from playfully jumping over puddles of water.
Jumping over or jumping in?
I don't know.
You just write this.
Have to step in puddles of water. Like, hey, you get back there and you step in that puddle right now, or you are going to juvie, buddy. I'm not playing. There are 3 puddles I watched you on the way to school.
Is anybody else getting a weird sound on the phone?
Not me.
That is so weird. Okay. I'm switching phones over here, trying to see if it's on my end. Just a second. I'm switching back.
In the meantime.
Hello? It's still doing it. Do you hear it, Robin?
No. No, I don't.
It sounded like when, remember when Steve went out to have a smoke? And it sounded like he was calling from Mars. What it sounded like. Maybe
that might have been what happened.
Speaking of Steve, he's on hold here. Poor Steve, he's been waiting. You know what? I'm going to go ahead and get Steve on the line. I think it stopped doing that. Cause thank God, because it was sounding really strange. I thought it was me. Oh, wait. Wait for it. Welcome to the show. Is this Steve?
I think so.
You think so?
All
hey,
I'm
Steve.
Hearing is like a... I'm just hearing like a steady, high-pitched noise in the background. I'm not hearing anything else.
Really?
Like now?
Yeah.
Right now?
Yep. Yeah, but I don't know if that would be, you know, it could be my... Now it's stopped.
I don't know.
Not here. That could be mine.
This just seems like the phone lines are kind of... sounding like almost like I don't even know how to explain it. It was weird. Okay. So what do you think about some of these laws that we're reading here?
Oh, we have some stupid ones ourselves.
Let me
do
look
you know
at
any
Pennsylvania.
Of them?
The list on California is holy crap. There's like 50 of them here.
Well, look how big California is.
Okay, Pennsylvania's got quite a few, too.
Yeah.
A special cleaning ordinance bans housewives from hiding dirt and dust under a rug in a dwelling. So you can't hide your dirt underneath the rug.
It's not.
No man may purchase alcohol without written consent from his wife. Okay, so what if you're not married? What if you're not married? What? Your mom? What if you don't have your mom? Then what? I guess you're shit out of luck.
Now, when were these laws written? That would be interesting.
It doesn't say. It just says they're still in effect. Nobody's abiding by them. I mean, you don't see people getting busted for these things, do you?
No booze for you.
Every once in a while, though, you see somebody get busted for, well, not really busted, they get nailed for something else, but they're held under some strange, obscure law. That keep you know that they can keep them until they have their case against them for whatever they busted them for.
You know, as culture changes, you think you know that you know laws would have a time duration. You know, like after I don't know 10, 15 years, maybe they need to you know. I mean, but what would be the reason to you know really convict somebody of dusting you know putting dust underneath their rug?
Yeah, exactly. I mean, they'd have to go to all the houses and pick up the rugs. Let's see. It is illegal in Pittsburgh, Pennsylvania to sleep in a refrigerator. Who in the would sleep in a refrigerator?
I would if it was 90. If I lived in California and all that smog, it'd be nice in there. All cold and everything. It's like 110 degrees outside. Tell me where you'd rather be, sitting on your leather
Matt's
couch,
like,
or sitting in the refrigerator.
Carly, just open the door every 10 minutes, all right?
It was only 69 today, by the way.
The state law of Pennsylvania prohibits singing in the bathtub. Oh, I wouldn't want to live there. I like to sing in the bathtub.
Well, it doesn't say anything about singing in the shower. You just can't sing in the bathtub.
But I sing in the bathtub, too.
Well, that's how people drowned. Don't you think of that stuff?
Oh, dangerous.
It's more of a safety law. It's a safety law. There you go.
Yeah, while you're getting your legs, you might lose, you know, distraction there. Might cause you to lose your grip on the blade and cut your leg wide open, right? In Pennsylvania, any motorist driving along a country road at night must stop every mile and send up a rocket signal, wait 10 minutes for the road to be clear of livestock, and continue. A rocket signal? Wow.
I know why now they all the men in Pennsylvania wear fanny packs. Need something to put the rockets in.
That's right. Depends on what rocket we're talking about.
Yeah, you fanny pack wearing men over there. No. I'm just kidding.
She's kidding.
This show does not promote anything against Pennsylvanians and your fanny pack. Thank you.
Thank you very much. Let's see. Let's just grab one or two from the other states, too, that are showing here. I'm sure there's more, but let's see. Alabama, it's illegal for a driver to be blindfolded while operating a vehicle. That's there for Cherie.
Well, that one kind of makes sense.
She's busted big time for doing that. My God. You better call up and defend herself. It is illegal to buy a bag of peanuts after sunset and before sunrise the next day in Alabama. Well, no peanut buying, not
what
after
sunset. What
would
be the reason for that?
I don't know.
Maybe the town doctor, you know, wasn't available during that time, so if you
a
choked
lot of
or something like that,
peanuts.
You can't help.
There you go.
I got it. Jimmy Carter wasn't selling peanuts during those other hours.
He didn't want to be interrupted. In Arkansas, a man can legally beat his wife, but not more than once a month.
What?
Yeah.
I'm never moving there.
I will never live in Arkansas, I guarantee you that. Flirtation between members of the opposite sex on the streets of Little Rock may result in a 30-day jail term.
Ooh.
God, I really don't want to live there. You can't.
Who would want to live in Arkansas to begin with?
But with. The Arkansas legislature passed a law that states that the Arkansas River can rise to no higher than to the Main Street Bridge in Little Rock. Oh, okay, so that, isn't that Mother Nature? Who are they going to bust for that?
She doesn't
Mother
hang
Nature.
Out in Arkansas.
We really don't want to live there. According to Arkansas law, no person shall be permitted under any pretext whatever to come nearer than 50 feet of any window or door of any polling room for the opening of the polls until the completion of the court and the certification of the returns. Okay.
Whatever.
That kind of makes sense. I mean, you know, people
so you don't interrupt things.
Need
that's
discretion,
kind of,
you know. Yeah.
Kind of makes sense. In Arizona, it is illegal to wear suspenders in Nogales, Arizona.
Nogales.
Okay.
Have you seen the people in Nogales, Arizona? You'd know why if you have. I'm just saying.
It's called Nogales, not Nogales.
Sorry. How do I know? You would know more than I would. You're the one that gets out there all the time when
well,
you were
you
driving
know.
All the time. Okay, it looks
she's
like
she's from
Teresa
Ohio, so she doesn't know.
Looks like Bree's calling in now. She wants to defend herself about blindfolding people driving. So let's get that. Call on the line. Hey, Sheree, are you calling to defend yourself?
No, not at all. I'm going to give you more.
Are you proud of blindfolding the people that drive in the car with you?
I'm glad they've got that cleared up because we have some stupid people here. No, I'm just kidding. one of them says boogers may not be flicked into the wind.
Well, that's polite. You know, you got to be polite.
Yeah, you don't want to land on other people.
Yeah, you just flick it towards the ground. Don't flick it in the air. How rude.
Yeah, or maybe I don't know, maybe use a Kleenex or something. Okay, so
I'm always on this one that you must have windshield wipers on your car. I don't say anything about having a windshield, but you must have windshield wipers. Well, knew about that one.
Masks
are not worn in public. We have Mardi Gras down here. Everybody thinks that New Orleans is the birthplace of Mardi Gras, but actually Mobile, Alabama is. We are starting Mardi Gras season now. So during Mardi Gras, we can wear masks.
Are you looking up laws over there, too?
I'm looking.
Yeah. Because I'm like, wow, she's got them all memorized.
No, I'm looking online. Putting salt on a railroad track may be punishable by death.
What? Salt on a railroad track. And this is
maybe
in Alabama, right?
Punishable by death. They've got to be making this up.
Okay, the next question. These laws are great, but the next question, is there a law, anybody in the group, that you break regularly that you know it's against the law, but you don't think it's that big deal, so you break it anyway? Anybody?
Jaywalk.
Okay.
Who doesn't jaywalk?
So you want us to go ahead and say on open radio in public the stuff that we do illegally? No, I don't think that's a good idea. I think I'll just...
No, that's not a big deal, you know.
Oh, that's not a big deal.
Like,
I don't know, though.
Litterers?
They're getting laws around here.
We better not have any people that litter, though. I hate that.
Under the NDAA, we may end up in a prison camp.
I tend to speed a little bit sometimes. Ooh, there's my dryer. Sorry, guys.
I didn't think it was your dryer, Robin.
Yeah, it didn't sound like a dryer.
Freeze out again? Okay.
Well,
wow.
Sometimes you speed a little bit, you know, in your car or...
Jaywalk.
Jaywalk, yeah.
I'm sure somewhere it's illegal to whip people. I like to whip people.
No, you do.
So, okay, I admit that.
Okay, some states, as far as I know, oral sex is still against the law.
Oh, those poor people. Oh.
Well, in Denver, Colorado, anal sex is against the law.
Everybody's so quiet.
Everybody's like,
somebody really
crickets,
wants to kill there.
Crickets. Crickets.
I'm waiting for you to use the whip.
I thought it was, you know, Matt or Steve would have jumped into that one. I thought maybe Matt or Steve would have commented. All the women just go, doo doo.
Doo doo doo.
Thank God it's illegal.
My daughter is on my lap, so Matt couldn't have said anything right now, but I would have. I have plenty of things that were going through my head. I'm just making that clear. I'm coming out.
You know, Matt, that's against the law in some states, too.
I'm sure it is.
My bad. Yeah, okay, I deserve that one.
That's probably one that isn't, that isn't outlawed in Arkansas.
So did anybody do their homework and maybe think of something else that they want to mention? Pretty funny, huh?
Yeah. What do you guys want to talk about, huh? A gripe? Something they want to talk about, get an opinion?
I'm tired of all these freaking these stupid-ass commercials on TV that have all the... They show one thing on TV, and if you look at the bottom, they have all what do you call them, stupid things?
Disclaimer?
Yeah, on the bottom, it's like, oh, why are you running this freaking commercial? You just, in the course of the 60-second commercial, you just disclaimed everything in the commercial.
It's kind of like, this pill can make you feel really good, but you could have a heart attack, stroke.
Sudden death.
Yeah, sudden death. Your tongue can swell, you can turn purple, but take it anyway, you'll be happy.
If you have trouble breathing for more than 5 minutes, call your doctor. Of course,
hey,
you know most people are sheeple, right?
Mr. Nobody from Montana's office before you do.
I want to borrow that sound clip when someone comes to my door and I don't want to answer it.
Make them think you have wild animals in there. We have a whole farm in your house.
Who is in there? What's going on in there?
It's
crazy.
Well, the telemarketers that call that you hate so much.
Or do this on the phone.
Yeah, that works. That works for
that
me
anyway. That will make somebody hang up.
Not used to that.
Hey, what about that State of the Union address? Wasn't that a crock?
I didn't hear
okay.
Listen to it.
Give us a... Oh, no, I want to hear what Dave thought about it.
I just can't...
No, I didn't even listen to it.
How did he find that many good things to say with all the bad things going on? Didn't mathematically work out, you could take up that much time and actually find some good things to talk about. You know, they things are so bad right now. Kenya, the leader of Kenya is saying, no, he wasn't born here.
Well, I suppose it would be a more depressing State of the Union address if he's like, well, I didn't fix anything. Nothing's working, and we're broke. So, you know.
Nothing and no one.
Cost more. Everything costs more, and you make less money. How do you like it?
I mean, it would be a historical, you know, State of the Union address, but, you know, would it be effective? I don't think so.
Well, yeah, but it would have been the absolute truth, you know. Yeah, no, really. He gets in front of the camera and goes, ladies and gentlemen, I really screwed up, didn't I?
Well, you know.
Thank you. Fire them all.
You know what Jimmy Carter voted for Obama?
He did?
Really? I didn't know that.
Yeah, because Jimmy didn't want to be known as the world's worst president of the United States.
So if you have an opinion regarding...
Baby, y'all up on the pool, giving the bottle, watching little drool. Wipe some little spit up on my shoulder. Now I gotta get him on the folding table.
Okay, I'm kind of wondering what just happened. What was that, please? Somebody explain to me.
Back in the 70s, there, man.
take you back time travel. Welcome
yes,
back.
Everybody, it is Free for All Wednesday. So if you're listening either on Facebook or on blogtalkradio.com, please call us. We want to hear from you. The number is
424-243-9676. Call now.
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 God bless you.
You're recovering a moment of time and space.
That's awesome. Someone needs to break a glass.
Someone needs to break glass. You think?
Yeah. It's part of the Twilight Zone, isn't it? Saying. Oh, okay.
The hell was that?
It's breaking glass.
I dropped something. Whoops.
I am so ecstatically in right now.
My favorite Twilight Zone episode is the one where the guy's, I love this one, he's stuck in that, in a prison cell. And he doesn't know it, but he makes a deal with the devil. Anybody seen that one?
I think I did. Sounds familiar.
Man, when I first saw that, I was young and it scared the heck out of me. I was like, oh no, that was the devil. He made a deal with the devil.
Yeah, but he doesn't know it's the devil, right, in the beginning?
No, he doesn't until the end.
Yeah. Yeah, I've seen it. I vaguely remember it, yeah.
That's a good
episode. I love Twilight Zone.
The Stephen King movie was like that, too.
Which one was that? I'm trying to remember.
That was the one where the plague killed almost everybody, and then, you know, the Colonel Flagg was the devil, and he went around and collected his little evildoers, and meantime, the old lady up in Kansas, or what, in Nebraska, or whatever, she was getting
totally
into people come see me, you know, and then they joined up together in Colorado, and eventually they blew the other people up, and it was cool.
You know, Colorado, Nebraska, satanic blazes, telling you. Totally. When I think Satan,
there.
I think Nebraska. Okay? Really. Not really.
No. You really just think of corn, don't you? It's corn. That's all I think of corn.
Well, Kansas has sunflowers.
Sunflowers are pretty.
I like sunflowers.
I like sunflowers. Sunflower seeds are extremely good for you, too.
Wait, save that for Sunday.
I have something that I want to ask a caller. Miss Denise Jane Black, have you gone on a paranormal thing lately that you could tell us about?
Yeah, like an investigation.
Thanks. Actually, we're currently trying to get together to start the new year. A little bit of setbacks with all of us in the group, but now we're going to have our meeting and we're going to, we've got a couple cases that we need to work on. And we were blessed with a reverend that moved to the area about 6 months ago or so. He belongs, basically he has an order, like he belongs to the Order of St. Michael's. And he came to our area, and he was looking for a professional group, some group, you know, because a lot of groups out there, they're not really, I don't want to say posers, but they're not really,
legitimate.
I mean, there's a lot of great groups, but then there's groups that really need some tweaking, let's just put it that way. But we pride ourselves in professionalism and, you know, taking it very seriously. We go to haunted places, like Civil War places in here in Fredericksburg for fun, for experience, but we also like to go and help families in their homes who have haunts and spooks and things like that. So we take it very, very seriously. So the Reverend found our website, which is Orange Paranormal Group, if anybody's interested. Take a look at us and you know, see what we're about. But he joined us, you know, he asked our leader, Victor, if he could join us, and so we're very blessed with him. So he has cases and families that that in the area that need our help. So I'm extremely excited to go and help the families.
Now, yeah. What determines whether or not it's a professional paranormal group or a non-professional paranormal group?
Taking it very seriously with respect, you know, it's. I mean, there's one point where you can just go and have fun and just get all kicks out of it, but we're not.
I mean, is there any kind of training that you have to have in order to be able to do that and be considered professional?
Yes, also. We're going to take a class, and I'm excited about that. We're going to take, like a day class, and we're going to get our license. So it'll be licensed paranormal investigators. So, so I'm very excited. I was just talking to him, Victor, last night about it. Like, we really got to get together and get on the ball here. And, you know, he's like, yeah, we got cases that we're going to work on. So, very excited.
Now, have you ever used an ovulus or a spirit talk? Isn't it a spirit talker? Is that what they call it?
Those are so awesome. The spirit box, you got to be careful, though, because, I mean, sometimes the words are just random and they're not really picking up anything. But there have been instances where, in other words, it was Easter, and it was like Saturday night before Easter. We went to a Civil War museum house and stayed the night in it. And the spirit box kept saying Jesus, Easter, bunny, basket. It was so cool. I was like, wow, this is my new favorite toy. Otherwise, sometimes it's just gone off random. I'm like, what is it talking? Where's that coming from? But, yeah, really, really, it's just fun. It's just really fun and interesting.
My nephew has that fun app, Ghost Radar, on his iPad. It's a small little hand job. Anyway, that's another show. And so I was kind of fascinated with it, playing with it a little bit. And so I turned it on, and I was in the kitchen, and it was saying different words and everything. I said, what's your name? And it said, sir. I said, okay, you're a man. What's your name? And then it goes, Dan. Freaked me out. I was like, oh, okay. And then so I started making dinner and just sat it down next to me on the counter. And then all of a sudden it goes, hungry. And then it said Washington a couple times. And I was like, that's weird. And he said, Aunt Robin, that thing never says words at my house. And he goes, see, 7, 1, 3. And he goes, it's already said 28 words. I'm like,
Oh, wow.
So, yeah. But
I sure
think
that happened. Are off of a word that you said while you were saying, oh, let's make dinner, and then it heard the word dinner, so it said hungry?
I don't know how those things work. You know, supposedly it's just an entertainment app, you know. And
yeah.
I just turn it on just for, you know, just to see.
I just figure it might have triggered something, you know, like if you say a certain word, then it tries to sound like
it
it's psychic.
It has a light that moves into the field. It's just for fun. And, you know, supposedly the color of the light is an actual. And then I was like, is there anybody there? My nephew's standing there. I was trying to freak him out, and I'm all, what's your name? And it goes, sir. And then I go, oh, you're a man. What's your name? And it goes, Dan. It was really weird. Yeah, it was like that. But he didn't get scared, so it wasn't that entertaining, but still.
That's Robin's part. She was getting scared.
Yeah. But, yeah, that's really neat, you know. I mean, what do you think about the whole paranormal thing, Dave?
I don't think about it at all, actually.
Sorry.
So
we have believers
in any of that?
Believers. Skeptics.
I could be normal, I guess.
You're normal?
So you don't care one way or the other, then?
Well, first is paranormal. I guess I'm normal.
I don't know if I'd call you normal, Dave. I mean, I don't think any of us on the phone line are completely normal. And that's why we get along so well.
Mm-hmm. Hey, nobody else knows those stories, Lisa.
What about you, Matt? Any paranormal experiences?
So let's rewind to those stories, Dave. No, I'm kidding. Mom.
What about you, Matt? Any paranormal experiences?
Yeah, actually, a couple. I used to work at a movie theater for like 13 years. It was the best job I ever had, right? But it was old. Like, I mean, it was built back in the 1935, actually, is when it was first built. I mean, I know a lot about the theater. Don't get me going on it. But the history of it, it all started with, I apologize, but I'm going to tell you the truth, you know, and to tell you the truth, I got to be blunt. Me and my friend, we were sitting there one night, I had to close, and we were just chilling back, getting high a little bit, right? And so we decided, hey, we're freaking stoned. You know, my girl and the baby, I know this is so bad, but, you know, I was the cleaner. I had to do my job, too, so I had to close down, clean up. My girl and the baby, they were sleeping. So it was just me and my buddy were the only ones there, right? Two people, just me and him, two guys. Right, and we're cleaning up, we get stuff done. Like I said, we were sitting there blowing up a little bit, and then we were sitting in the women's restroom. Because if you've been in the theater, you probably none of you have ever probably been there, but they used to have this carpeted room, like for the women in the women's bathroom, and it was like mirrors on one side, and the whole room was just carpet. So you sit against it and just relax, it's all soft.
Yeah, it was a nursing room basically to nurse
or to put their makeup on and things like that. Women fuss in there.
Yeah.
And so we're sitting there, and we decided to pull out our cell phones. Well, I pulled out mine. He didn't have a cell phone. I pulled out my cell phone, and I just hit record. You know what I mean? Just record. And we were sitting there kind of messing around with it. And you can hear us in the background. You know, we're coughing, da-da-da. And towards the end of it, like the recording, because I was sitting here, I wasn't paying attention, and I had my headphones on one day listening to this recording on my computer. And it was like you could hear this woman, like a woman speak or something. You couldn't make out what she said, but then you heard like this baby cry. Like it was like quick seconds, like the last seconds of the recording. It was like shh or something. Like, and you just heard that, and I don't know what it could have been, but that's what it sounded like to us. And I had other people listen to it, and they got the same results pretty much as I did. You know, they heard a couple little things here or there. And then so me and my friend were like, okay, this is a little serious. We're going to take it a step higher. We actually, you know, got a recorder, an actual voice recorder. I had like two or three of them, and we got the tapes, we got batteries, and we decided we're doing this. We're going to do it, and we're going to do it right. We got there. I closed down again 10 o'clock at night. We set up. We were ready about 11 o'clock. We had video cameras. I mean, we had it all. We even had little things because we're thinking, okay, if it's a little kid, maybe we can try to, you know, coat it with a stuffed animal or something.
Matt?
Hey, yeah.
One question. Did you get stoned again?
No, actually, this time we did not.
Oh,
okay. Because we were thinking, you know, maybe that could have been what it was. But, I mean, other people heard the recording. But we wanted to be straight A, because if we seen something, we didn't want to, you know, have the influence. You know what I mean? We wanted to be straight-headed when we went in there. So that way, if we seen something, we knew it was an actual something that we seen. It wasn't something that, like,
I just seen something, man.
You know what I mean? And so we didn't want it to be like that. So we went in there straight-headed, and we had, like I said, the recorders, the cameras. I think we stayed until, like, 3 o'clock in the morning or so, 3, 4. And we were in there all night, just switching tapes out, switching da-da-da. Like I said, for the little kid, we tried to set up, like, this little doll in the women's bathroom. We tried to set up, like, little dolls just to see, and we had the camera on the doll to see if maybe it got moved or whatever. It didn't. Just it cut down. Like, did it move? No, it didn't. It didn't move or anything like that. But we did get a couple more voices down in, like, the auditorium area, which sounded like two men holding a conversation. And one of the said-to-bes, the entities that are inside the building, is actually the mayor that the building was built for, which his name was J.P. Kiggins. The building was actually named after him. He was the mayor of Vancouver in 1935. And so they made the theater for him. They think, because the story is that he actually committed suicide off the I-5 bridge, and that he stopped by all his businesses, because he owned a good amount of the businesses that are on Main Street and actually throughout downtown.
Yeah,
he actually
had
like a part of all the businesses. And so they were saying that he goes there, and so and we got a smell of like cigar smoke. We're in the women's bathroom. We got like, people don't believe in orbs. I'm not a big orb believer. I think orbs, you know, you got dust, you got things around the air. But this one was an unexplainable one because it seemed like it came out of the women's bathroom towards the camera, kind of shot up to the left a little bit, kind of came back to the, and then just boom, like bigged up and then smalled down. And so that one was like, okay, that's pretty crazy. What else do we get? Just more voices, pretty much. Just a couple voices here or there. We had other employees with their stories. You know, I mean, too, I believe everybody when it came to that place, because there were things, I mean, we were taking a picture one day, and I took like four pictures, same spot, four the same pictures. And the second picture in, this one kid, his name was Sean, because we were doing like an employee picture, his name was Sean, his face was all like blurry. You know what I mean? Like in The Ring, I think, or something like that. His face was all blurred out. But the other three, it was fine. He was fine. So that was kind of one of the weird ones, because we were actually talking about the auditorium being haunted at that time when I was taking the pictures. So for that to have happened, you know, pretty much that's all I got. That was long as hell. Sorry.
Well, it looks like we've got another caller waiting on the line. Oh, wait, and Cherie's back. I guess Cherie got either booted off or had to step away for a moment. So let's go ahead and get Cherie back on the phone and the next caller after that. Cherie, are you there?
Yes, I'm back.
Oh, okay. Were you having phone problems or did you need to step away?
No, I saw her text message, so, you know.
Okay. Well, I'm glad you got back on. We were missing you over here. I'm like thinking, where's Cherie go? Okay, cool.
Oh, whatever. You didn't know I was gone.
How old of a phone do you have that you can't answer a text and be on the phone at the same time?
What's that?
But how old of a phone do you have that you can't answer a text and be on the phone at the same time?
Well, it's a new phone. Well, I've had it since November, and I was trying to, it wouldn't work, so I just said, I will call them back.
Ah.
Gotta have 4G.
So I will work on that, so next time I will not have to hang up, okay? I think that was Steve talking.
Yeah
it was Steve.
Okay.
No worries, Cherie, no biggie. Looks like we've got another car. Let's go ahead and find out who we've got on the line. Welcome to the show. Who am I speaking to?
Renee.
Hey, Renee.
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 Hi, guys.
Hey,
Renee.
Renee.
Hey, woman.
Hello. Hello.
Hello.
Tell us about your shoe,
hello,
Renee.
Pardon?
What happened to your shoe, Renee?
Yeah, you were something about your...
That's one of the most recent ones. Well, it's kind of an odd story. My daughter's girlfriend was in the hospital for a long time, and they let her for about a month, and they let her out, and they were contradicting her diagnosis, and they let her out, and she got to my house. She was on a strict diet because they thought it was pancreatitis. And they put her on a strict no-fat diet. So she came home. They were long and short of the story. They were going to go out and get some mashed potatoes and gravy ice from KFC. I said, no, we can do it here at the house. So she put my shoes on, which are like mule, but they were Skechers. And so those are like clogs that you can just slide your feet into. And she was like, oh, mamas. These are such comfortable shoes. I think I'm going to have to steal these from you. Well, the next morning, my daughter went to work, and I told her I'd wake Mercedes up at, you know, about 9 or 10 so she can go get her prescription filled. I couldn't wake her up. And so basically we had to call paramedics.
Oh, that's sad. I'm sorry.
She never woke up. They took her to the hospital. She was brain dead. And they tried keeping her body and organs alive so that she could donate them. But before they were able to harvest them, she died in the hospital. So ever since then, I could not find a shoe, one of the those shoes that she put on. And about, I want to say about 9 months later, I was moving the couches, and I do that like once a month, move the couches, you know, sweep behind the couches and mop, and lo and behold, it was there. No dust on it. I had moved that couch several times before that, and there was the shoe.
Wow.
Another time I took off, and by this time I was separated. I was living in the house alone. My daughters had moved out. I came back late one night, and a friend was with me. Well, I keep the door to the room that she died in closed. When I got home, the door was open. I was like, we closed that door, right? And we're like, yeah. The door was open. I turned on the light, and the mattress was completely, the bottom half of the mattress was almost completely off of the bed, touching the wall.
Oh, wow.
The box springs were fine, but the mattress was about, the bed set about a foot and a half away from the wall, and it was way over there, almost touching the wall.
Do you have a dog?
I have a Shih Tzu.
Oh, okay. Well, that doesn't count. You have half a dog, okay.
I have two Shih Tzus. I was pretty doubtful they could have done that.
I just
Mountain
wanted to interject
maybe?
That
Bear?
I'm back. Okay, I had to close
wait,
out my shift with the other staff. But so this is Danielle telling the story?
No, Renee.
No, it's Renee.
Oh, hi, Renee. I put the phone down, so now I'm catching back up, and I'm driving home in my loud car. So, okay.
Hi, sweetie. How are you?
I'm good. Good.
Yeah, she used to mess with me all the time. What was that?
Can you talk on the phone and drive there?
Of course she has it on speakerphone attached to her rearview mirror, of course.
Oh, of course.
She, of course, is not holding it to her ear. Because otherwise there'd be problems, right?
See, that's another thing we do illegally. We drive around with our phone sometimes.
Oh, yeah. And that's what happens.
I can't remember your car.
Who's ever been pulled over?
So since I was abruptly interrupted at work, gee, what did I miss?
The show is archived and recorded, Denise.
Yeah, Denise.
And
we'll just rewind it in the middle of the show and play it back for you, okay?
What was the link? How do I listen to the show again?
Well, all you have to do is enter in Blog Talk Radio. Actually, it's the same link that you have. Well, actually, you're on the phone, so you can't do that. But when you're at a computer, it's the same exact link that you use to get onto the show online. It's the same link. It has the archived show. Or you can go to Blog Talk Radio and look up Shadow Lady 7 or Talk in the Shadows. Either one will bring you up to my show, and you'll see all the archived shows.
And, you know, I was also trying to cue Robin into doing announcing.
Well, you know, I was going to, but, you know. It's okay. It's her show.
No, I'm kidding. I'm playing.
Uh-huh.
Oh, come on. It's all in fun.
Oh, yeah?
Our spider lady, guess what?
Whatever, Rob.
I'm a lover, not a fighter.
This is Robin right now.
Oh, that sounds just like me. Yeah.
It's identical.
Oh, by the way, I am drinking room temperature water right now.
You go, girl.
Proud of?
That is awesome. All right.
Just like you taught me.
That's supposed to be an audience sound effect, but it sounds more like a vacuum cleaner.
Are the sound effects, like, long and annoying tonight? Anybody agree?
Yes.
I agree, yes.
Hello, man.
Me.
But that one never gets old. I don't know why that is so funny to me. I have no clue.
Do you have a deep dark secret about that?
What?
I think it's funny. That's funny to you.
What? Excuse me, Steve? That's why. I'm asking her if she's got a deep dark secret, and that's why she's giggling.
I didn't say anything.
Yeah, you did.
Wow.
Oh, yeah.
Do you ever feel on the outside looking in? I don't know. I'm kind of confused here.
Or do not be able to distinguish between the sound effects and real people.
This must be cryptic. Hey, let's call Talk in the Shadows and be cryptic. Yeah, okay. Yeah.
Wow.
You know, I know the perfect time to use that. When you introduce me. And my
co-host
is Robin.
Okay. Someone likes themselves.
Now, everybody that doesn't like me out there in Radio Land is saying, yeah, look at her. Yeah, see how she is.
Talk in the Shadows Radio now with THX Sound.
Oh,
the
audience funny.
Is now deaf.
That's the best
okay,
part
Robin,
of the movie,
when you
when
aggravate
there listening
this.
I think that's the best part of a movie for me, though. I love that. When I'm sitting in a theater and you hear that, I just love that. Why do I love that so much?
Because it gets you all worked up for the show, right? It's like, builds it up.
Yeah, it's just like, I don't know. I'm a real audio person.
No, you need that
love
before you're in bed having sex. Right before an orgasm.
You know, that would probably be really neat. I wonder if I could cue that up.
Cue that.
You
next
knew
to the bed.
Lisa, you knew where my mind went right away, didn't you?
Yep.
I'm totally audio driven.
Right away.
I love to be in the midst of music or sound or love it. It's good stuff.
Yes.
I read you, Robin. I mean, not Robin,
that
Renee.
That was not me singing,
sorry.
By the
me
way.
Me, arse.
Yeah. So.
Wow.
Hello?
Hello?
That explosion kind of set everybody up. That's what we'll do when people are screaming over each other. We'll do the bomb.
Can anybody Can anybody do any impressions? Anybody?
Oh, I know Dave can.
Really?
Oh.
Come on, Dave. Do
what?
A couple.
Wait, what?
Think of one and then announce it and do it, man.
Um.
this is the 18 and over show, so go for it.
Well, I really don't know what to say, but I think that last night. That's great.
All right. Do you got one more? Do you got more?
Do I got what? Well, yeah, but I, you know, come on. I got to think about what I'm going to do.
He's not warmed up. I know how that is.
You know, you got to give me a tablet with some of this shit, man.
Well, he's been sick, hasn't he?
Yeah, that's probably part of it, too. He feels a little under the weather today.
Yeah, give him a break.
Right. Wait a minute. Did I sound like cheap or what?
A little bit. I heard it. I knew who you were doing.
Oh. No, I asked you if I sound like cheap.
Robin knew who he was doing.
I know.
I knew what you were doing.
My mind is so in the gutter today.
Me too.
Oh, at least I'm not alone.
All right. Where's your wings and let me come inside?
Now, Lisa, you can do some accents, can't you?
Oh, God, you're putting me on the spot. I got phlegm. I've been drinking a lot of creamy coffee.
Russian accent.
Russian accent.
You know, have you ever been in a group of singers, you know, and I think any singer out there that is saying will recognize this. Here's my dryer again.
Robin, is that fun? Isn't it nice?
Okay, so anyway, well, you know, you get in a group of singers, and then you ask somebody to sing, and all of a sudden, everybody's had every throat ailment in the last 24 hours. It's like, oh, I've been sick.
Are you making fun of me?
No,
you start
to
get
that,
aren't you?
They
oh, man,
that,
if you were
though.
Closer.
You know they do. Well, I'm going to sing the song, but I've been sick. I mean, come on.
I would sing it, but I'm not feeling well.
Just do one.
Sorry.
I'm sorry.
Dave, we're not mad at you. That's just Robin. She's on the rag today.
What? What did I do, huh? Can we not talk about my menstrual cycle, please? Let's just avoid that whole area, please.
Maybe we need some peaceful. Yeah, that's the ticket.
So I'll do my joke. That has an accent in it. Can I do my joke?
I don't know.
Yes,
can you?
Ma'am.
Come on, let me do it. This is 18 and over, right?
Yeah.
Oh, my God, you sound good.
I said we
so
need something
guy,
deep.
You know, he decided
to go to the bathroom now. I went by.
Now, see, you guys are going to have to determine whether or not he went to Scotland or Ireland by my accent, because I really don't know, but I do this accent, but I'm not really sure what country it's from. But he decides he's going to go find himself, you know, so he goes to the home country. And, he, you know, it's beautiful, and he's, you know, he's down by the water, and so he walks into this pub. And he walks in this big, beautiful door, and he walks in a beautiful bar just spread out right in front of him. And he's got these
spread
wooden
out.
Homemade, yeah, these these wooden homemade stools. And he sits down at the bar, and the bartender's on the other end, and he says, "Bartender, give me a pint of your finest." So the bartender pours the beer, you know, and he slides it down to the guy, and the guy, it just glides into his hand, and he
puts it in
his mouth and takes a drink. About that time, there's a guy sitting next to him, on the, a couple stools over, and he goes, "Hey, laddie." And the guy says, "What, me?" He goes, "Yeah, laddie, you see the stool you're sitting on?" He says, "Well, oh, yeah, I built it with me own two hands. I cut the wood, I did. I sanded it and I planed it. But do you think they call me McGregor, the great stool maker?" And he goes, "Well, I don't know." And he goes, well, they don't. I can't believe I'm telling this joke on the air. So then the guy says, wow, this guy's pretty upset. Starts drinking his beer a little bit faster. A couple minutes later, guy goes, hey, laddie, you see the dog? You see the, see, I can't do it now. Oh, I'm just totally not going to do it.
Well, thanks a lot for bringing that up.
Do you see the door you walk through? And he says, well, yeah. And he goes, I built it with my own two hands. I cut the wood I did, and I sanded it, and I planed it. But do you think they call me McGregor, the great door maker? And he goes, I don't know. And he goes, well, they don't. He slams his fist down on the bar. The guy's going, okay, well, I got to get out of here. So he just as he's finishing his beer, and he goes, hey, laddie, you see the dock out there? And he said, well, yeah, I see the dock. And he goes, I built it with my own two hands. I cut the wood, and I planed it, and I sanded it. But do you think they call me McGregor, the great dock maker? And he goes, the guy says, what, they don't? He goes, no, they don't, but you fuck one goat. Da-da-da. Okay. I give up.
But we definitely applaud you on your accent.
What?
That was funny.
The accent was off.
That's about as far as I go.
Well, with the name being McGregor, I think he might have been Irish. Maybe.
I'd say it was Irish.
If you are Irish or Scottish, please call. Then the number is
424-243-9676. Call now.
Yes. Sorry if my language offended those that are. Yes.
Please correct Robin on her accent.
My God, I just so cannot believe it.
If you do not like my joke, please call 424. Tell us about it.
I did not like your joke.
I did not like your joke.
No. I've got a heart of me little shillelagh.
So, anybody see any good movies? Maybe the new Sherlock Holmes?
Oh, my God, there's so many good movies coming out now I want to see.
Anybody? Anybody get their eye on a movie?
Yeah. Chronicle. Who wants to see Chronicle?
Yeah.
Oh, my God, I want to see Chronicle.
Now, who's in that?
I don't think there's anybody really famous in the movie, but it's about these kids that they mess around with being able to have these special, abilities to move things and do really freaky things. Like, they start, like, in the preview, they show this little girl about to grab a stuffed animal, and they make the stuffed animal, like, come down from the top of the shelf and, like, just, like, slowly glide down in front of her and land on her. It scares the crap out of her. And they do a bunch of other stuff in the preview. And then basically the one kid gets way too out of hand with it. He becomes really talented with it, and he starts making a big mess of things. And it just looks really good.
So kind of a creepy movie then.
Yeah, like supernatural kind of creepy. Of course, Dave won't go see that because he doesn't believe in that. But, yeah. Or will you, Dave? Would you see that with me? If I lived near you and I said, hey, Dave, let's go see Chronicle, would you go?
Oh, yeah. I'm there. I don't know why I'm there. I just want to be with you. I'm there.
Okay. You're like, the whole movie would be like, this is so gay.
He's normal, but he'll be paranormal. For
he'll be normal to hang out with me.
Yeah.
Aw, that's sweet.
That'd be normal.
So anybody else looking at any of the new movies out there they want to see? How about TV shows?
Teen Adventure.
A lot of really good shows.
Beastmaster?
That was Yeah, Ink Master.
Oh, Ink.
Ink.
I was going to say Beast Master's quite old.
No, Ink Master. With,
so it's about tattooing, right?
Say that again. I didn't hear you. Say it again.
Ink Master. I-N-K.
I-N-K.
I know. I just think it's cute.
So what is that supposed to be about?
They're competing, tattoo artists competing to be the master of tattooing, I guess.
Oh.
And they have Dave Navarro as one of the judges.
Oh, okay. Yeah, I think I saw previews for that.
So what do you think of Dave Navarro?
Yeah.
What do you think of Dave Navarro?
No way.
Mm-hmm. Yum.
Okay.
Especially
Renee's already in high.
Especially when
okay. Talking about hot guys. What about the show Grimm? Anyone else watching Grimm?
Nope.
No.
Well, I haven't seen that. I don't really watch TV, so
you're the only one, Lisa.
Grimm. Oh, can I? Oh, wait. I probably shouldn't say that. I do have Bill. Ooh, whoops. Anyway.
Can I? Oh, I lost a momentary lapse of reason there. Never mind, I didn't mean it.
Yeah.
Don't watch it. It's not good.
I mean, you know, if I wasn't taken and so in love, I would definitely go for the guy on the show.
Well, it's okay to appreciate someone else's
beauty.
How can I put this? Why are you calling him on Steve?
Charisma. What is that noise? Somebody's organizing the drawer kitchen.
I was printing something.
You're printing something?
Yes.
Damn, that's a loud printer. Might want to get that looked at.
I was standing right over it.
He's, you know what it is, Lisa? He's jealous because you all have all the sound effects. He wants to add a few of his own.
Oh, okay, that's the printer. Okay, that's a good effect. Now we'll add that to the list. Printer sounds.
Yeah. We're not that be his special thing.
I thought I heard a sound effect for flicking a lighter, but then I realized he was just smoking a cigarette, so.
Yeah, I don't have that sound yet.
Well, he does have the alien sound effect as well, you know.
Yeah, see, Steve doesn't follow the rules. Steve's like, you know what, I'm not going to mute my phone. They can hear me go to the bathroom. They can hear me print something.
Well, it is a free-for-all. Well, shoot, I'm going to go
pee now. My coffee, whether they like it or not. And everybody's going
to
listen to it.
That's it, I'm peeing on the air. No, I'm kidding. I'm gonna carpet on the air.
But at least I didn't flush. I'll wait till after the show.
Yeah, let's do a show where everybody calls from the toilet.
That's right. It's the Toilet Tuesday.
Toilet Tuesday.
I hear all the echoes.
You hear plop.
Sorry.
Yeah, some things are just not very good idea, I think.
My grandmother always talked when she was on the toilet. Not on the phone, but she'd talk to you through the door. She'd be like, hey, if you want to go somewhere, I left the 4 keys over there on the counter.
Wow. Did you answer like this? Did you say... Oh, okay.
No, I just went like, thanks, Grandma.
Thanks. Oh. That's funny.
Okay,
yeah.
Grandma! Anywho...
Back to the show.
Ba-dum-bum-ba-dum-bum.
Your grandma left us speechless, Dave. We don't know what to say.
Now we all suddenly have to use the bathroom. Oh, Doug's here. Yay, hi, Doug. Call in the show. Hi, Dougie.
You know, he needs to rewind this and listen to the whole thing later because I think he got a really big kick out of it.
Yeah, no kidding. It's simply awesome. How was that? Oh, it's awesome.
You won't do an accent, but you're going to do like that?
What, Beaver? Or Butthead. That was Butthead, actually. Oh, you said awesome. That's cool.
Yeah.
He's kidding my song.
Wait, what was that? I think someone was doing Cornholio, I think.
I did Cornholio.
Yeah.
I ain't
going to
say
that.
He's kidding for my bunghole. Ah!
Oh, my God.
Wow.
So I can't even be here with my eyes. So silly.
Sorry, Mr. Hanky the Christmas too.
Mr. Hanky.
Well, I know.
Dave can do Mr. Hanky, I bet.
You see him.
I know.
Oh, Dougie's on the line. Let's answer it. Oh, wait. We need doorbell. We haven't been using the doorbell.
Yeah,
you can either know me, either Tom.
Hey, Doug. You there, Doug? Doug?
I'll just
Doug.
I'm Chris Hansen with Dateline NBC.
Chris, thank goodness.
I'll just be your secret lover. I'm Chris Hansen. Did you bring condoms?
Hey, what's up?
The sky.
Hey.
The economy's low, but the taxes are high.
Well,
yeah.
Definitely
know the economy.
No.
So yeah, I see you got the soundboard off. Now, are you getting that off of E-bombs?
No, I found a couple different ones on the internet.
Yeah.
Yeah, but he can't say it, tell you his source,
hey,
or he'll get
baby.
Busted. Be very, very quiet. We're asking what?
What you got in there, good to eat? Fried rice taters?
Biscuit.
So what's going on?
Oh, nothing.
Well,
we've been sitting for you.
That's
we
you
don't
guys
really say anything.
What are you talking about tonight?
Just you,
we shared a
Doug.
Joke. We
just
talked
me?
About movies.
Again?
We talked about
yes.
We talked about Paranormal Activity. We talked about
Paranormal Activity the movie.
No.
We talked about Dave's grandma in the bathroom.
Yeah, we talked about that.
How about that? Yeah, I think I heard that. She's the one that talks to the bathroom door.
Yep.
Well, yeah.
She's doing her thing.
Mm-hmm. Just shaking off
can't
a little.
Crying in her voice.
Not my grandma.
No disrespect to his grandma.
I'm talking about my grandma that way. The woman is fine.
Sorry.
So sorry.
Dave here tonight or not?
Yeah, he's there. We were talking about his grandma.
He just talked.
Oh, Dave's
yeah.
grandma.
Dave,
yeah.
not
thought
your
you said
grandma.
Somebody else.
No.
That's
so I missed
grandma.
A show on water. How was that?
The water show.
My water.
It was a wonderful water show. Wonderfully waterful. Actually, yeah, it was a good show. Yeah.
Well,
where were you? How come you weren't
remember.
There?
When was
where
it?
You?
Sunday?
As
oh,
always.
Yeah. You didn't want me in there on Sunday.
Why? You were in a bad mood?
No, I was drinking all night watching football.
Uh oh.
Then I came
what
home.
What a manly
so.
Activity that is. You know?
Yeah,
well,
that's
yeah,
what my
you
wife
can
thought.
You can save that attitude for men or for Mars when you're on the show.
that
don't
attitude.
Forget about it.
See how immediately abrasive you are?
No,
football's not an attitude.
What?
Watching football's not an attitude.
Well,
yeah,
the kind of
we like to do.
Watch games have that guy attitude, right? And Matter for Mars is going to be all about guys and what makes them tick. So, and don't forget, you're supposed to be on that show. Like, you promised me.
I will be on that show. That's going to be on a Sunday, right?
Sunday, yes, indeedy.
Mm-hmm. Sunday.
what is Sunday's show?
You know, and if you guys are going to call in, you know, really prepare yourself because we really we want to know what your opinion on
what
that topic.
What are you going to expect from us?
Right.
Well, you are a man.
A very large penis.
No, your perspective on things.
Yeah.
Thank you, Sherry, for that commentary.
Sherry,
see, why can't we get her name right? I don't know.
That's just you, Robin.
I think Sherry,
sorry.
Okay, Sherry, calm down.
I'm comfortable with my sexuality.
This is so random,
well,
you guys.
What would you expect from us?
What do you mean, feedback?
No, as far as when we go first, the women go first.
What?
We like when you go first. What do you mean?
Yes, the women are going to go first. They're going to be on the 19th of February. The men will be on the 26th waiting in their line.
Me first.
Waiting in line behind us, ladies first, of course.
That's okay. Well, you'll give us plenty of material to work with, I'm sure.
Well,
I don't know if that's a very good strategy.
You've got some built right in.
Now I'm confused.
Now, okay. The shows, all right, let me just go ahead and explain. I'll just do that since we're sitting here talking. Okay, so the month of February is going to be all about love, relationships, and men and women. Okay?
Yes.
February 5th. Sunday, always Sunday, is going to be romantic ideas and tips. So this is for all of you men, especially, and some ladies, who are having trouble trying to come up with good ideas and some romantic things that you can do for your beloved.
Sexual device out of his
mouth. Yeah, so as I said, romance, you know, that's the problem. So, that's what that show is going to be all about. And then the second show of the month is on the 12th, which is also Sunday, always Sunday for the subject type themes. That's Valentine's Day Madness, and that's just going to be about talking about Valentine's Day and how it got its start and people's opinions on it, whether they think, you know, it's important or if it's just made to make money for card companies and flower shops and things like that. Then the third week on the 19th is Women Are From Venus. And that's all about women and what makes them tick. We're going to have a panel of three women. I've already chosen them. They've already agreed to go ahead and do that. And we're going to have the male callers call in and ask them questions, basically grill them. Why do you do this? Why do women say this? Da-da-da. And we're all going to talk about women.
Oh,
okay.
No.
And then the 26th is Men Are From Mars, and it's the same thing, a panel of three guys. And the women get to grill them about why they do what they do.
Now, see, the interesting thing is, too, is that, you know, the women may have a different opinion. So if the guys ask the question of the women, you might get two or three, well, obviously three, different answers. Well, and same thing with the guys. So it'll be interesting. Everybody can kind of put in their two cents on what they think. No, dude, I don't agree with that. Or, yeah, I agree with that. Or whatever. So it'll be nice.
So maybe we'll walk away with a little bit more understanding about the opposite sex at the end of this month coming up. Maybe.
So maybe on the guy's show, they might say something like, I don't know.
Oh,
I'm more confused about the opposite.
Something sounding like Butthead or Beavis.
Yes. Yeah.
I know. How about our expectations of what we want from women out of
absolutely
line.
Absolutely.
Yeah, we could talk about that too. All of that.
Absolutely.
You got it.
Because
Robin
I don't
and I are the queens of absolutely. Absolutely.
Yeah.
Some, you know, someone just absolutely flat out will not do what you want, so you go, hey, Monica, come in here.
Yep. Then you'll get an answer.
Wow.
That was loud. Who did that?
Doug's on fire. It's dueling.
So we got some freezing rain coming down in Cleveland.
Yuck. That's what I have to say about that.
That's good stuff. Maybe the kids will actually get a day off school.
Yep, maybe.
Wow.
Or not.
Probably not.
Probably not. They slide their way to school on skates.
I'm ready for summer already.
Pure adrenaline.
It's summer down here.
The beginning of February, and I'm ready for summer. I'm just not a winter person.
I'll take spring, seriously. I don't like it. I don't like it.
Yeah.
I don't like it at all.
I don't like it.
Just not a fan.
Once that is before Christmas at work, some people decide to steal our AC units outside. And what's sad is that our company has yet to replace them, and we actually need them because we are sweating to death every single day at work because it's so warm down here. And it's in the middle of January. Why is it so freaking hot? I mean, it's not like super, super hot. It's like in the 70s outside, but it gets so hot on the inside and everything. I'm like, it's January. I remember being out in a football game freezing my tail off. It snowed like, you know, a few weeks after that, which is very rare down here and all. And here we are in T-shirts and shorts and all kinds of stuff. So I'm afraid our hurricane season is going to be really bad.
Well, have you heard about chemtrails and geoengineering?
Yes. Who can miss them out in the sky?
They're trying to create global warming of some kind.
And they're making us sick with all the chemicals that are dropping into our air and into the water and destroying our plant life. I know.
I watch them go back and forth all day long. I mean, they even make U-turns. Show me a commercial airplane that makes U-turns and then make another one.
No, sometimes there's three or four of them at a time, all making formations. Yeah, and they're definitely not doing it for 4th of July.
No. No, it's not an air show. These are great big honking jets flying at 70,000 feet, and they're laying out big old lines of white shit. And later on in the day, to make the whole sky white, you know?
Yeah, and let's go ahead and tell the difference between a contrail and a chemtrail. A contrail disappears within seconds, whereas a chemtrail can sit there for sometimes, what, at least half an hour, something like that? So you know the difference.
I watched two of them today. One was a commercial airliner making about a six-second contrail, and the other one was a sprayer going back and forth, and his clouds lasted all day long.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, it ruins our beautiful blue skies. You know, we used to be able to look up and see the beautiful, crisp blue air, you know, blue sky and the nice, clean air, and you could breathe.
Now, why are they doing
so? Why do you believe that these chemtrails are happening, Dave?
Well, because I can see them happening. So that point is moot. As to why they're doing it is the big question.
Yeah, well, I definitely have opinions on why they're
doing
it.
Who's they? See? I mean, who is they?
Who do you think it is?
Well, they are government-owned airplanes. That's been proven. They're government-owned airplanes. Because we are apparently private airliners are not allowed to follow them.
Oh.
If we could, I'm sure somebody would take samples of the air somehow as they're laying this stuff out, but we're not allowed to do that.
No, it's because they're trying to be sneaky about it. I don't know how they could be any more obvious, though. I mean, they're doing it in sight.
I know. And in the Central Valley, Ricketts is up 70%. you know, that's a disease that affects children that don't get enough vitamin D from sunlight.
Exactly. Well, they're blocking out the sun's rays. They don't want us to stay well. They want us sick. You know, whether you believe it's population control or whether it's to have us have more medical bills so they can make more money off of us, whatever you might think it is.
Tree foliage is down 30%.
Oh, yeah. I had to pull out 6 bushes out the side of my house because they all turned brown and died, and they were there since I was a little kid.
Did you water them? Sorry.
Oh, yeah. Are you kidding? Of course. I didn't just suddenly change and start doing something different. No, they were dying, and I had neighbors that started ripping theirs out as well because they turned brown.
I know, but you say the government, and you, what side? What side of the government? I mean, who?
There
Congress?
Is no side. They're all the
President?
Same coin.
I mean, everybody? Is there like this secret puppet behind the government that's saying, okay, let's chemtrail our people? I mean, I'm being devil's advocate here, but I want to know your opinion.
Well, first of all, Congress just refunded it in December. They funded something that they're not doing that doesn't exist. Why did they fund it?
Mm-hmm. Why would you fund something that wasn't really there?
Exactly.
Yep, just like the whole Patriot Act got renewed, and then we've got all these other new laws that are just continually taking away all of our rights.
The Nightmare Act. Oh, sorry,
yep.
Dream.
What's that? Can you tell us about that?
Oh, that one's basically amnesty. You know, you're from another country and you're here illegally? I'll send you to college. We'll pay for it. Middle class will pay for it. You're all good.
Yep. But if you say something they don't like, they'll just grab you up and throw you into a jail with the NDAA. You have no chance to defend yourself either.
Oh, yeah, that's an executive order.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, those executive orders are getting to the point where if something big goes down, all of a sudden we have a dictator.
Yeah, they might just cancel the whole election, too, so it won't really matter who gets elected. And guess who gets to stay in the seat of presidency?
The usurper.
Okay, what do you think, Denise? Denise?
Hmm? Sorry. I was at home.
I think Denise fell asleep. Either that or she's blocking it all out. It's too scary.
She's standing under the chemtrail.
She's out there snorting a line of it.
Pretty fluffy clouds, man. From the way she describes her car, that is a chemtrail.
I think so. She's going to get pulled over. Hey, you want a job?
I
see how well you continually pollute the air with your car. Maybe you'd like another job.
You might as well.
Hey, you know, though, but we were talking
exactly.
To you. The neat thing about that whole thing is we were talking to Denise in December and she didn't have a car. So congratulations, right? Because you were saying you needed a car. Or are you needing a car because your car's smart? Or are you needing a car?
The car's a POS. It's a POS car. It's a 93 Crapola. And it needed a lot of work done to it. I broke down in December. And I was like, oh, my God. You know, so then Dad helped me because he does mechanic work. And we put a lot of money. He replaced, like, all the parts and everything under the hood. And I was helping him with that. Every time we got, like, one system done, then it was, like, another system. And it was just... Car's been a nightmare for the whole month of December, and you know January now I'm actually driving it, but it's just going to be at a point. It's just going to be, you know, I need to get like another car, something better, much much better. It's a great deal, but I'm just not. It's just not my ideal. Believe me.
Somebody got a good deal out of her, but it wasn't you.
No, Jane in Black needs a black sports car. That's what she needs.
Some weird sound effect.
Black Lincoln Town Car would be all your speed, right?
I think it's the dance because of the girls. Like, now I got to go get my, have my girls, the three girls in the car and stuff. I'm hoping to have a weekend with next month, so.
How about a pimped out Pinto?
Pinto, God.
Painted black stripes. Cool, man.
You could probably still find an AMC Pacer somewhere.
Now, she couldn't put her kids in that.
A gremlin.
Making that. Yeah, a gremlin. There you go. What were those cars that looked like bubbles? We just called them bubble cars when we were kids. They had like a big, like, bubbled rear window and front window.
Yeah, that's a Pacer.
Beagles? The Beatles?
Oh, no.
You know, I was patiently waiting the new Dodge Dart. I was patiently waiting the new Dodge Dart that was coming out, and pulled it up on a website to look at, and I thought, what the heck? It doesn't even look like a Dodge Dart. How they're making cars to this day, I don't get it.
No, they all look like bubbles that are going to take flight. Remember when cars used to have nice lines, nice sharp corners and edges?
Yeah, they don't have any body. They don't have any body style anymore.
Sexy anymore?
Right?
They just look like misshapen boobs. I mean, they don't look hot. They don't look really good in
You know what I don't understand is all this stuff they talk about with the fuel mileage and all this other shit, and all these people are going out and buying that Honda Element and that Zion or whatever you call it that looks like a freaking box on wheels. But none of them things get good mileage. Freaking square.
Yeah, exactly. Everything's turning into geometric shape.
Right.
Next is going to be the triangle car.
You know, unless you pay top dollar for a car. And I mean, I'm talking money that probably none of us have ever seen. You know, Ferrari. I mean, really nice. You know, you look at the car, you're like, whoa, that's sexy. But, I mean, the normal everyday car that we can afford, you know, can we really get a sexy car? I don't know.
No, we don't stand out. See, that's the problem. They don't want us to stand out. We can't be unique. No one's allowed to stand out. We all have to be a bunch of sheeple.
That and they're too busy putting crap in car inside the car that you don't freaking need. I'm sorry,
exactly.
But if you're that lazy, you need a car that you can talk to it to change the temperature because you're too freaking lazy to move your hand over there and turn the heater up or down, then you shouldn't be driving to begin with. You're paying $40,000 for a car that has this crap in it that it's like, why don't you take that out, put the knobs back in for the heater, and drop $10,000 off the price.
You got it.
You make money then.
Let's welcome Doug back to the show. Looks like he had a problem with the phone. You there, Doug?
I'm here. Why'd you cut me off?
I didn't cut you off.
I did it.
You did it. Bad. You're bad.
Yeah.
Thought we're complaining about cars and how ugly they are and how they put more money into the insides than the out. What do you think about that there, Dougie?
I don't know. I've been driving the same car for about 8 years, so I drive my Vibe, GT.
Yeah,
it's a,
like
a sweet ride.
Don't you do that?
I got a 2003 SS Monte Carlo, and I think it looks fine, and it doesn't have all the, you know, that was before they started putting all this stupid iSync shit in it, and everything else to wear. Hell, the dashboards on some of these things, you need an engineering degree to operate them.
It's like flying an airplane, huh?
You know, Shadow, I think you have one of those, but it's not a GT. Never mind.
You got these things now where if the computer shit goes down.
We can send you an expansion pack and make it a GT.
I just use a plug-in. Who needs batteries? Okay.
Wow, Alyssa put a nice car up in the chat there. That's sweet.
Yeah, Lamborghini's my favorite car.
Is that a new Lambo? Sure is.
Sweet!
If I had an extra 250
Ooh, that
around.
Is fine.
Gotta look at that. Hold on. Oh, yeah, that's nice.
If the tires are hot.
Beautiful.
Woo! I just want that car. Can someone buy me that, please? That's all I want for Christmas next year, or this year, I should say, next Christmas. So if everybody will just call in with PayPal payments, I can get my dream car. Please.
It's going to take quite a few of those.
Wow, that's a nice car.
Beautiful. Fiber.
Does it make love to you when you get inside?
I imagine that one would.
I think it does.
Yeah, the airbags do more than what a normal airbag does.
They reach out and touch you. What about the stick drive? Anyway.
Don, Chris Hansen with Dateline NBC. Did you bring Connie? I want to wrestle you so freaking bad.
Your car is so sick. I want to put my thing in it.
Wow.
Now that's a pickup line.
Car likes when you're spread eagle.
Robin's losing it.
When you get in the car, it makes this sound.
That's funny.
What is that noise? Is somebody washing dishes?
Nope. Cutting graphics.
Ew.
God, I love that sound.
What are you doing?
Cutting graphics. I made graphics
I had the phone muted so you guys didn't hear me after the sound effect went off, but that's like, I love that thing. I want to put it on my answer machine, so all you hear when you call me is, oh.
All right, I'll send it to you. Send it. I'll give it to you, Robin. I'll give it to you, baby.
Thank you.
A ringtone.
What was that?
Put it on my phone as a ringtone.
You're going to put on your phone as a ringtone? Cool.
Yep.
And for people who don't get calls...
Those
is that my phone not ringing?
That is unbelievably long today.
Sorry, that's what the sounds are like. You're impatient today, Robin.
I know.
Is
what's
that,
up with
that? It's that time of the month for you, isn't it?
So we have 15 minutes left. Anybody have any interesting things that happened to him this week?
More like 11 minutes, dude.
Oh.
Other than this radio show?
So what we want to tell Steve is get out more. Oh.
Hey, guys, no, a close friend of mine had surgery today, right?
Oh.
Yeah, I definitely said a prayer for them. Did you find out anything?
Well, no, because they wound up doing a biopsy. And they won't know anything for 5 more days.
Ooh.
Yeah.
Well, I'll definitely keep them in my prayers and hope that it comes back, that it's not malignant.
Is it two people that had surgery or one? Because you keep saying, I'll keep them. Oh, it's one person.
Right. Well, he's not saying who it is, so we're just kind of calling them because we don't know he nor she, so.
Oh, okay.
I'll say.
Rob, was that you again? You really need to calm down with that thing.
We hope that your friend is fine, and hopefully it isn't malignant. Best wishes to your friend.
But 5 days of complete and total nervousness, and you know that's going to be rough.
Yeah, that is
hard. Yeah. Oh yeah.
I'm probably going to go visit her on Saturday.
Good. And you should.
Yeah. Yeah. Most of you know who she is, but I can't say anything, you know.
Right.
Anyway.
Okay. Well, everybody just say a prayer for someone important in your mind, and hopefully that will help. Or if you don't believe in Christianity, then send positive vibes and good thoughts.
There you go.
To Dave's friend. Good job.
Dave's friend, yes.
Well,
so,
best of luck to your friend. That's hard news to take.
You know what I'm doing. I'm going through everybody's walls, and you guys are going to get it too, but I'm going through everybody's walls and wishing everybody a Valentine's Day, but I'm also, you know, early Valentine's, but I'm also looking at everybody's statuses so I can catch up on everybody's lives. And I am sad. I mean, like, there's a lot. There's like a handful of people that are losing their pets and they're losing their family members, and it's like, oh my God, this is not a way to start the new year. I feel so bad for our friends. You know, so
yeah.
All my heart for all the people that are losing, you know, people who are sick and going through starting out the new year with these surgeries and illnesses and death. Oh, my, so sad.
Some
yeah.
people are getting out while they're getting good, you know.
Yeah, I hear you.
It hasn't been the best year yet.
I said some are getting out while the getting's good.
Mm-hmm. Right. Sometimes I think about my relatives that are already gone and somewhere else, and I think, God, sometimes I wish I was there. You know,
yeah.
I mean, all that's going on in this world, it's only getting scarier. So the people that are already on, they're the lucky ones.
You know, but there
yep.
is a reason that we're all here, you know, and we can look at the negative. We can look at all the horrible stuff. But really, too, you know, in looking at that, we really got to look at, you know, how effective we are in caring for people that are around us. So that's another thing that you can think about. I mean, I know it's hard and everybody's like, oh, end of the world and everything. But, you know, just the people that you're involved with in your life, that you've chosen to be in your life, you know, you can encourage them and be there for them. And certainly our friends that are going through things, we can be there for them. Because unless we are, you know, then, you know, sometimes you just need somebody to be there for you. And
yeah.
That's what we can do.
Well, obviously, if we believe in God's plan, then we're all here for some purpose. Maybe my purpose is to spread the word on the things I know about, and maybe your purpose is to help me and do other things that you help others with. You know, I mean, we all have some reason why we're here, even if we are suffering in different ways.
We're here to experience it, whatever it
yep.
is.
That's right.
And it might, some of it may be good right along with all the horrible. I mean, from what I've heard, you know, like the whole, we already talked a little bit about the Mayan calendar last show. But, you know, a lot of people are saying it's a different, we're going into a different state of being, a different state of mind. The whole world is supposed to go through a change. Doesn't necessarily mean it's all negative. It doesn't mean it's the end either.
No, I think at the point we're getting at, some of it would have to be positive at this point.
Or otherwise it would be the end. Yeah.
No, I mean, even if there is some big transition, which, I mean, seriously, we can't be more than... No way we're more than 50 years away.
Well, you know, if you look at it, though, born out of tremendous tragedy, whether it is a country, whether it's you in your life or something, born out of those experiences are incredible triumphs and appreciation for life. So, I mean, you can go, well, you know, it's got to get better. Well, you know, maybe it won't, but maybe out of that we'll find a way that we can all get to a place to where, regardless of what is going on around us, we still have peace. Or we still have people around us that care and support us. And, you know, I mean, it can't be all doom and gloom, right? What's the purpose of living?
No, you're right.
You know.
No, you're exactly
right.
Well, there's still too much good in the world left, even though we seem to focus on the negative. I'm guilty of it, too. But we have to remember there's still so much beauty out there that we can't ignore.
You know, we don't always handle things right. I don't always handle things right. Shadow, you don't. I'm sorry. No, but but
no, she is naughty today.
I'm giving you a hard time. You didn't pay the right sound effect. Yeah, you got to play the right. No, the other one.
Oh well, you're not a guy, so you like that one. I'm not giving you what you
like. That one. Okay.
I don't care. You
well,
don't
anyway,
like it.
You know, what I'm just saying is, so every day, you know, people that knew us 5 years ago, we may be in a different place. We may be in different situations. So I don't know what to say. The only thing I'm trying to say is that hopefully everybody can, regardless of what's going on, that everybody in some way will learn from their experience that they're having. That's my hope anyway.
Well, I think it'll bring people together, you know, that are meant to be together and make us appreciate each other more. I mean, you know, when you see things ripped out of your hands and things just go to crap, you realize what's really important. And what really is important is the people in your family and the people who are your friends that you love and trying to do good for each other and trying to help each other out. And I hope that mankind kind of pulls together and we get through this. You know, that's my hope for the world.
Hmm. Yeah, I don't think we're getting through anything until some bad shit happens, though.
So we're going to have to, when the shit hits the fan, we're all going to have to pull together and we're all going to fall apart.
Or starve to death, whatever.
Yeah.
Well, what's sad is that, you know, sometimes that needs to happen. And people say, well, what do you mean it needs to happen? Because, I don't know. Why? Why do we need adversity? I don't know. Do we? Do we really need it? That's a good topic.
It's definitely an eye-opener.
Exactly.
Well, it's probably part of the constant plan, really.
Yeah. There's definitely a plan here. I mean, you can't deny it. Even if you don't believe in God and you don't have Christianity, you just got to sit and think. It just looks so planned out. Even if it's mankind planning it out, something is definitely planned here.
Would you see that movie?
We're certainly the tail wagging the dog, that's for sure. Sorry, Dave.
Mm-hmm. What was that, Dave?
No. That Cage movie, the Knowing. Who saw that?
Yeah, I think that's what it's called.
Oh,
yeah.
Nicolas Cage. Yeah.
That was about this world ending and a new world beginning. But only two kids got a ticket.
What's it called?
The Knowing or Knowing? Yeah.
Oh.
Well, it looks like Matt
Knowing,
is back.
I think.
Let me squeeze Matt back in here the last couple minutes of the show. I'm sorry. Let me go ahead and grab him.
All right.
Hey, Matt, you got your phone charged up?
Yeah.
All right, cool. Yeah, we got like 2 minutes left here, so we're just winding up. You got it in the nick of time.
The nick of time.
Sorry if I haven't made any comments in chat tonight, guys, or about chat. I'm not looking at chat, but we certainly do welcome everybody that did listen to the show tonight. Thanks for coming. Hope you enjoyed it.
That's a weird word, right? Nick of time. Hey, Nick, got the time?
Well, since we're winding down the show, I just wanted to let everybody know again, this is going to be for this month. This is the last show for our Free For All Wednesdays. We're going to take the month off next month and resume having the Free For Alls. I'm thinking just one per month, but we'll see. We may end up having two a month. But they have definitely been a lot of fun, and it's really interesting to see what we veer into. Sometimes we start off with one topic and end up a completely different place at the end of the show. So it's been absolutely a blast.
Every
My time. Bottom hurts.
Your bottom hurts? That's the other end, right?
I got a gay. I got a tube that's been gay. I can rub it on for you.
Ooh, we've got some loving going on here.
So we do appreciate you listening today, and we do want you to like us on blogtalkradio.com and also follow us on Twitter and Facebook. Lisa?
Yes, and that's www.facebook.com/talkintheshadows. Please like our page. We would love your support. And don't forget, this coming Sunday on the 29th, from 10 p.m. till 12 a.m. Eastern Standard Time is our last in the series for Living Well in 2012, Exercise for Your Body and Mind. So that should be an interesting show, and I'm looking forward to that. So hopefully you guys will join back in and enjoy the show with us and call in and with questions or anything you'd like to add to the show. That would be great. But
and if you disagree with exercise or being healthy, call in too. We want to hear your side.
Yeah, we want to hear your side. Okay, so I'm just going to go ahead and say goodbye to everybody and thank everybody again for calling into the show. It's been a lot of fun, as always. And hopefully we will see, or I should say talk to you again in the shadows on Sunday. So love you guys. Peace out. Bye.
Good night,
everybody. Talk to you guys later.
Bye, everyone. Bye.
Bye.